feel bad, but this place is really filling up with people living here. How many of us are there? A lot.
Iriko! I brought all the elves that were still wandering the forest!
Come on, baby.
Now there are even more. So are they all women? Where are the men? I don't see them.
There weren't really any men who survived the human war.
Oh, wow.
But that's okay, really. I wonder if some sort of terrible problem has arisen.
Hey. Sorry for calling you all here like this. There's something I want to talk about with all of you.
Next episode.
Run, Todd!
I know that, Master. However, it would be a nuisance for everyone here if you were to stay too long. Now, let's be on our way while they're still happy to call us their guests. They were even kind enough to gift us.
Oh, yeah. They give us those apple-looking things.
They're called apples. And don't worry, they gave us plenty of them.
Yeah, whatever. I'm heading home.
Don't transform yet until you're outside, okay? But I should really decide how the Great Tree Village is going to handle visitors, welcome guests, or otherwise. Diplomatic relations? This is all getting complicated really fast. I've been thinking about a lot of things since then, and I believe it's not good for us to keep visitors outside when greeting them. With that said, I'm not comfortable inviting them in. So I've decided that we should build a guest house for visitors. I was thinking a house able to fit 4 people would be enough.
No, I think that would be far too small. Wait, anyone coming to this village needs to climb mountains and make it safely through the forest. Our visitors up until now have been servants of the Demon Lord or Dragons. However, normally when people come here, they'll be doing it in large groups. If that's the case, then I think we should play it safe and build a house that can fit 30 people comfortably.
30?
We'll make the first floor an open space designed to hold feasts. And we can make the second floor into bedrooms for our guests if they want to stay a bit longer.
That works. And that's how we got started building a guest house for any potential visitors. Next, I wanted to work on how we greet new guests. Grand Maria and the angels are in charge of defending the perimeter. And rather than finding visitors and guiding them here, they would capture visitors and bring them to the village entrance. On top of that, when Zabuton sounded the warning alarm, everyone would grab their weapons and get ready for battle. It's a long way off from a proper welcome. So we came up with a new signal for visitors. Leah and the elves made a bell. Next, we discussed how we treated our guests. I suggested that Tia and I would be the ones to greet the guests.
I cannot agree with using such a small welcoming party.
She's right on that. Enemies might take advantage and sneak in disguised as visitors.
My idea was rejected. So, we added a few high elves, a scattering of ogre maids, and lizard men to our welcoming party. Flora wanted to be part of our welcoming party as well, but I asked her to keep an eye on any visitors that stay here until nightfall.
Understood. Please leave it to me. If you'd like, I can keep watch the entire time they're here.
That's when I learned that Flora and Lou could go several days without sleeping and be fine. But I still told them not to overdo it. All the preparation we did got put to use. Much sooner than I expected.
My name is Garth. We've traveled from a place in the mountains east of here called Howling Village. We want...
It turned out that the beastmen from Howling Village weren't trying to trick us. They really did want trade relations.
Now then, let's talk about our trade agreement.
Come on, baby.
Yes, our trade's different. We trade physical goods and...
Next episode.
In charge of handling diplomatic relations here at the village.
Don't tell me you're that dragon girl.
I am. Please call me Lesti. What is it that you've come to request from us today?
We'd like to get more of those bright colored fruit we got last time.
You mean the oranges, right? I'm sorry to say our stock is running quite low. Could I interest you in strawberries instead? They're perfectly ripe now.
In that